Okay, let's talk about the difference between the relative velocity and a resultant velocity. Right, so let's start about the relative velocity. So if we are talking about the relative velocity, we are talking about the relationship between two moving bodies, or else we are talking about the difference between two moving bodies. Like for an example, let's say you have body A, which is moving directly east at a speed of 20 meters per second. 20 meters per second, okay, directly east. And then we have body number B, body B moving at a velocity of 30 meters per second, directly west, right? So if we're talking about the relative velocity, we're talking about the relationship between these two bodies, or the difference in a speed. Like if you are passing, maybe you are moving on a highway, and then you are passing this car moving at the speed of 30. So this car will over you will see this car traveling at the speed of your speed plus his plus he it a speed, right? So therefore you will see this car moving much faster than it is moving in reality. So that is the relationship between the two of this car. So like let's say the relative, or calculating the relative velocity of A related to velocity number B. So if we're calculating the relative velocity is equal to the velocity of body A minus the relative velocity of body number B. Like, because body B is moving in the opposite direction of B, therefore is moving in the opposite direction, is going to have negative 30, right? So therefore it will be 20 minus 30, then will give us 50 meters per second, right? If you are in this car, then the relative velocity, the relationship between these two moving bodies will be 50. Like, so is the same as maybe if you're having, again for an example, body number A, which is traveling at 50, okay, let's say 50 meters per second directly east. And then you have another body, which is body number B, moving directly east, right, in the same direction. Maybe it's moving at an maybe at a 60 meters per second. Right. So if you're calculating the relative velocity of body A related to body number B, the relative velocity will be the velocity of body A minus the relative velocity, okay, the velocity of body number B. Then it will be a 50 minus a 60. Then your answer, it will be negative 10 meters per second. So in a car moving at, okay, you are in a car moving at 50 meters per second, and then there is a car which is car number B, is moving at 60 meters per second. You will see this car moving at 10 meters per second, because you already moving at 50 meters per second. Therefore this other car will be moving at 10 meters per second, right? So then if this car will overtake you, it will overtake, body B will overtake body number A at 10 meters per second. So this is the relationship between body A and body B. So if we are talking about the relative velocity, we are talking about the relationship between these two cars, right? Like if you are in body number A, which is 50 meters per second, is moving 50 meters per second, and then body number B passes body number A which is point number B, will be moving 60 meters per second. But you will see this car moving at 10 meters per second, because already you are moving at 50, and then this one is more with 10 meters per second, right? So unlike in a resultant velocity, so here in a resultant velocity, we are only concentrating on one body, right? Let's say we're having body number A. So in this body, there will be two or more velocity acting in this body. Therefore, it will then, if we are calculating the resultant velocity, we will be calculating the velocity that will balance all those velocity acting in this body. Definition of a resultant, right? The definition of a resultant, they say the resultant here is the resultant of two or more forces is the single force that can replace the two or more forces of the more forces and still do the same amount of work, right? So this is the definition of a resultant, right? So, but here we are not talking about forces, we are talking about a velocity. Like if we have a velocity, okay, let's say this body A, body A is moving at a speed of 30 meters per second, right? Okay, if body A is moving at 30 meters per second directly east, right? Directly east, and then we have we have an external force acting on this body. Okay, maybe this force is pushing, already this body is moving at a at 30 meters per second. And then we have an external force like air, or like wind, or any other forces that is not in the system that will push this body. Maybe it will be pushing this body at 10 meters per second. Right. So if we are talking about the resultant velocity of this, it will be the velocity that will replace these two velocity. So then the resultant here will be 10 plus 30, then it will give us 40 meters per second, which is the resultant velocity in this case. So if this force, if this body A is being is moving 30 meters per second directly east, and there is a force, an external force, which will be pushing this body in directly east again. So if this would be pushing this body directly east, and then the resultant velocity, it will be 40. This is the velocity that will replace these two velocity and still do the same amount of work. So